is front-end development easier than back-end? So there are a lot of opinions on this topic, and some people think that one is substantially more difficult than the other. In this video, we're going to discuss some of the easy and difficult aspects of both sides. But first, we need to take a step back and analyze the story of the modern web. In 1979, ARPANET, which we can consider the Internet ancestor, delivered the first message from one computer to another, a simple string. Things kept improving until, in the 1990s, Tim Berners-Lee invented the World Wide Web, which was basically a collection of websites interconnected with each other through links. Compared to what we have today, those websites were simply static HTML web pages containing text, images, and links, and without any real form of dynamism. As the need for dynamism increased, two improvements were made. On the front-end side, in 1995, JavaScript was introduced in Netscape Navigator and later in Internet Explorer, which made web pages more interactive, though still very far from what we have today. On the back-end side, dynamism was introduced by making the server return a custom-rendered HTML page depending on the request, rather than serving a static one. For example, if you searched something on Google, the server would respond with a custom HTML page containing the search results. At this point, the use of client-side scripting was stagnant, and JavaScript wasn't really that useful yet. Things started to change when AJAX was introduced in 2005, allowing clients to request new data from the server without refreshing the page, and making them much more dynamic. Soon after, libraries like jQuery were introduced to simplify DOM manipulation and AJAX requests, especially across different browsers. At this point in time, most of the complexity related to web applications was located on the backend, with the front-end clients being much simpler. So at the time, back-end development was indeed harder, because although the incompatibilities between different browsers were a serious issue on the front-end, the complexity of those front-end clients was not even close to what we have today. But things drastically changed when Angular and then React were introduced. Those front-end web frameworks became hugely popular in 2015 as they allowed developers to create the highly rich and complex web applications users wanted. Just think about the incredible things you can now do in the browser that were impossible to do 15 years ago. So we really needed to consider the current state of front-end development in order to effectively compare the two. 10 years ago, the front-end might have been easier, but as the power of client-side applications increased exponentially in recent years, so did their complexity. With this being said, let's see how the two compare in various areas. When it comes to getting started, front-end development is generally easier than back-end. That's because, in general, you only need a text editor and a browser to start experimenting with those frameworks. Of course, you might need to run a couple of commands in the terminal to set up the project and install the dependencies, but it's pretty manageable. On the other hand, backend applications often require to set up local environments with databases and other services to actually experiment with the application. Of course, you might get away with SQLite at first, but that's not always appropriate or even possible. In these scenarios, Docker is often used as a way to set up the local environment, and although it's not particularly complex in most cases, it's definitely an additional obstacle for beginners. An area in which front-end is arguably harder than back-end is state management. You see, unless your app serves hundreds of thousands of users, the backend can usually be structured as stateless server instances, interfacing with a handful of services such as databases and caches. In this scenario, it's reasonably easy to reason about the server logic, as it follows a request-in-response-out semantic. On the other hand, the front-end client has to deal with a state that is several orders of magnitude more complex. Reasoning about state is really hard, and that's the reason why libraries like Redux were invented, to make this huge state management mess easier to handle. Of course, this aspect really depends on the application. Some might have complex frontends and simple CRUD backends, whereas others might have simple frontends and incredibly complex backends, so it depends. Another interesting topic is responsibility. Both front-end and back-end engineers are hired to build great products, but back-end developers tend to have more responsibility. First of all, it's much easier to make a catastrophic mistake as a back-end engineer, as you are directly interacting with databases and other core services. Of course, there are a lot of best practices you can follow to limit the risk, but they are not always followed, especially in smaller or old-school companies. And in those small companies, the role of backend engineers often overlaps with DevOps, making them also responsible for keeping the application running. Both frontend and backend technologies have been evolving quickly in recent years due to the increasingly complex features demanded by users. On the frontend side, users wanted richer interfaces. Just think about Google Docs or Figma, which are fully fledged applications running in the browser. On the backend side, users wanted services to be always available, reliable, and fast. For example, 15 years ago, it was completely normal to schedule downtimes for maintenance, but they are often considered unacceptable now. And that's why tools like Kubernetes were created, to simplify the creation of always available services. But although the backend is getting increasingly complex as well, frontend technologies tend to evolve at a quicker rate. For example, 2 years ago, React hooks were introduced and completely changed the way React apps were built. But if you think about that, React only became popular 3 years earlier, so in a 4-year span, React developers had to relearn a lot of things. This is to say that front-end developers might need to study more in order to keep up with new technologies and stay relevant. So to conclude, neither front-end nor back-end is substantially harder than the other. They are simply different things, each with its own set of challenges. Most importantly, the complexity of both sides depend on the specific projects. Alright, so that was all for this video. If you liked it, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, like the video and comment, and I hope to see you in the next one.